not funny.
Get cell
That's
phones.
Like not funny at all.
Oh.
Chakor didn't think so either. Sorry.
Well, I got an idea.
What's that?
Maybe if people dance, they'd forget about my joke.
I think you're right. Come on, everyone. Let's dance at the next Chicago Groove. Public announcement. Right here on Chicago Groove.
Mamacita, where you at? Been trying to reach ya. All alone, you know I need ya. Got me fiending, can I meet ya? I need to see ya, hesitating. Can't do that, don't keep me waiting. On the floor, it's getting late and got me fiending, trying to reach ya. Mamacita.
Hey there, shorty. I've been feeling you like them jeans do feel me. Like the way you move, what the deal, young filly? Can I get my groove on? I've been waiting long enough. You got to lace me up just once. You know you can't deny me when they playing our song. A little bump and grind, yeah, you know ain't nothing wrong. Say, won't you give me time, say they playing our song.
Patty cake, bake this man. Let me see you shake it like I know you can. Why you wanna tease me? Got to give me some more. Come on, come on.
Come on.
1, 2, 3, what you gonna be? 4, 5, 6, baby, move them hips. 7, 8, 9, you're running out of time. Come on,
come on, come on, come on. Come on.
Hey. Mamacita,
Mamacita,
where you at? Been trying to reach ya.
Trying
all
to reach ya.
You know I need ya.
No,
got me feeling, can I meet ya?
Oh.
I need to see ya.
Chakora's going to help me. Coming up next year on Chicagogo, we're going to kick it in with the Mary Jane Girls singing In My House. My house. Right? And I would like to welcome our first guest here on Chicagogo, a great, great Chicago band made up of really good looking, fun guys, Frisbee!
Thank you.
love you, Frisbee guys, at any age. Hi, Frisbee person. What's your name?
Liam.
Hi, Liam. I really like your guitar.
Thank you, Mia.
It's kind of a fun guitar.
It's a Fender Stratocaster.
All right. Did you paint it yourself?
No, I didn't. It's a friend's.
All right. Well, good taste for you and your friend.
Thank you.
Hi, Frisbee person. Oh, sorry, what's your name?
Hello. Bill.
Hi, Bill. I like your shirt.
Thank you.
You guys have matching shirts. Where'd you get them from?
I got them from Steve.
All right. Well, we'll get to him in a minute. Hi, Frisbee person. What's your name?
Eddie.
Hi, Eddie. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you. It's great to be back.
Yeah, that's kind of a funny looking bass you have.
Yeah, it's abbreviated.
For what's it short for?
I can't tell you.
Okay, maybe you can think about
where we got the shirts, though.
Okay, where'd you get the shirts from?
We got them in Tennessee.
All right, well, there you go. Tennessee to Chicago. Hi, I guess your name's Steve.
Hi, Mia.
Hi, can you tell us a little bit about this?
It's our record called The Subversive Sounds of Love, and it's really quite good.
It is. It sounded really good. What was that song you just sang?
Momentito.
And what was that about?
It's about you don't get very long, so do it now.
Live it up?
Actually, it's more like do it now and be ready to let go when it's gone.
And speaking of letting go when it's gone, were you guys big Ramones fans?
Well, who is it?
That's right. Well, I hope you guys stick around and dance because we're going to have a tribute to the great, late Joey Ramone. Thanks, Frisbee.
Thank you.
Bye, Joey. We're going to miss you. We love you. Thanks for changing the face of rock and roll. And coming up next, we have from Cameo, another blast from the past, Word Up. Does everybody remember this song? Word Up.
Y'all pretty like dance around the
genuine quest to have Cheap Trick here on Chicagogo in the year 2001. We have our Cheap Trick song coming out, one of their best. Cheap Trick, if you're watching, please come on the show. We love you. Cheap Trick, please. We're all dancing to you guys all the time. Like we're going to do right now. Have to come on the show. Up next here on Chicagogo, our second fabulous set of guests here on the show, one of Chicago's coolest, neatest bands, Mystics. Woo! Come right up.
The nouveau riche are prowling the streets of what used to be the barrio. They're lined up outside the club Versailles and the cabaret Romano, where the pricey liqueur and posh decor are designed to amuse and delight. The royalty of the new economy and the various parasites. Stack those condos up to heaven, tear another tenant down. Time to send the paupers packing, the gentry's coming to town. Boy with the bald of an ancient Greek god in a glossy magazine.
DJ's wheels grind to a halt. She collapses in the back of a taxi cab, feeling like a pillar of salt. With the drugs wearing off and her head against the door, still living those 15 minutes when she was queen of the floor. Starting out with the Sun King, dived out like Marie Antoinette, but the revolution's coming. Dear, you better watch your head.
On your door one day, you'll bleed and beg, but it'll be no use, because ignorance is no excuse. Say au revoir to your bourgeois dreams and bonjour, bonjour, guillotine.
My name is Eric.
Hi, Eric. And excuse me, guys. Hi, what's your name over here?
Hi, I'm Susie Brack.
Susie Brack. Very great performance. And over here, well, hi, what's your name?
Emo.
Emo, like your glasses. Okay. And I want to hold up some of your CDs that you have here. Hey, can you guys stick around and kick off our fantasy dance?
Certainly.
Yeah, the first song's by Mel C.
Hey.
All right. Thanks, guys. Thanks, Miss Tex.
No problem. Thanks for having us on the show,
sure.
Mia.
Sleep through the lonely night.
who can turn me around when I'm upside down? I turn to you.
Sorry, Ratso. Ouch.
That show was kick butt.
That was
a show of shows.
Oh, my gosh. It sure was.
You know what would make today's show perfect?
No, what?
Viewer mail.
Okay.
Let's read what some of the nice people have been writing in.
Yeah, it's really nice to get correspondence from everybody at home. And
you can write to us or email.
That's right. You
we
can
might
draw
read
pictures.
On the air.
All kinds of things. Here's a letter from, it's from Anonymous. This is a real email that we got. They didn't say who they were.
Okay.
Let's see, I'd like to read this. Ahem. I would just like to recommend, spelled recommend wrong, that you take your ahow, they must mean take your show, off
you're
of the air. Because it is the worst thing I have ever seen. Wait, get this? Where in the world do you find these people? The concept of your show is ridiculous. The people on your show should be locked in a padded room or something.
Wow.
Just wanted to let you know. No signature.
Wow.
Don't know who that one's from.
Wow,
Ratso.
It finally happened.
What finally happened?
I can't believe it.
What?
The letters are finally getting nicer. We must be getting much better.
The letters are getting nicer. Oh.
They didn't even curse at us in this one.
They sure didn't. And you know what? If any of you at home want to write us or draw pictures of us or keep in touch with Ratso or Miss Me or anybody here on the show, you can write to us at the address. Especially nice ones. Coming up on your screen after we dance to James Brown.
Yeah, get your pencil.
Bye, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Bye-bye.
Get off of my tip. 'Cause I'm James Brown with the force.
Full force.
Ain't taking no lip.
Thanks for watching for 5 years. With the special Chicagogo R2D2 hotline telephone. And we're gonna be doing some really cool over the phone interviews with some participants in the very first Chicagogo episode. Let's see who we're gonna call next. Hey everybody, I am on the phone with Dave Sisson of the Three Blue Teardrops. They were Chicagogo's very, very, very first musical guest, 200 episodes and years ago. Hi, Dave.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm great.
So, way back when, on the very first Chicagogo episode, you were on.
Yes, I was.
And can you tell us what that whole experience was like?
Well, I nearly sprained my ankle dancing with the Black Lone Ranger.
Uh-oh.
But aside from that, it was a great experience. And in fact, I did get a copy of the show, and I've showed it to people over the years, and they are just absolutely amazed and astounded.
Oh.
I don't think I realized the part of history I was playing as it was happening, but as the years have passed, I realize now that I was a part of history.
You know, in many ways, but definitely you are a landmark in the Chicagogo history, you and the band. Can you tell us what you felt like when you showed up at the studio? And, you know, as you remember, I was there too as a friend of you guys's, and none of us knew what to expect, right?
That's true, and you know, as a matter of fact, they told me that we were going to just be. Many people may not know Mia, but we were in fact lip syncing to a record. So,
as you
watch the clip, you'll notice that I'm not singing in the right time. And if I could have done it over again, I would have done it like a bad Elvis movie where I would have sung purposely, really poorly, so that none of the words would have looked like I was actually singing them, but I actually did try to sing with the song, so.
You did a great job.
My regret is that I would have done worse.
But, you know, I think you did do a pretty bad job, but it was a good bad job.
Very poorly, and then I think I got better as I figured out what was going on, but.
Well, what do you think about me ending up hosting the show years later?
Isn't that weird? Because you sort of just were there as a dancer, and
yeah.
Next thing you know, you're behind the helm. You're like Captain Stubing of the Chicagogo show.
The Chicagogo ship. And, you know, I must say thank you to you and Rick Upling and Kevin Myers, because if it wasn't for the three of you guys and the Three Blue Teardrops bringing me and actually my mother, who was visiting at the time, to that very first taping 5 years ago, I don't know if I would have been hosting the show today.
Well, you're welcome. I'm glad I had any part to play in that.
Yeah, it was great. And actually, speaking of your infamous clip, we're going to roll in and take a look at us. Can you tell us what song you lip-synced to?
We were lip-syncing to, I believe it was Hard Boiled.
That's right.
I believe that is it. Yeah, Hard Boiled, and I had the George Jones haircut going on there. I was like the guy from Madness, and that's pretty much it.
All right.
All right, well, let's roll in and take a look at it. Thanks, Dave.
Yeah.
Miss Jackie Stewart. She is the backbone, the skeleton of Chicagogo, the behind-the-scenes internal strength to every episode and everything we do.
I try my best, yes. I love Chicagogo. It's a great show.
Well, you are the best. We couldn't do it without you, Jackie. You know that.
Oh, thanks, Mia. You're the one. You're the star.
Oh, no. We just put the smile on the face. Anyway, so ever since episode one, Jackie has been in the control booth, editing on the fly and producing and directing the floor and everything. And 5 long years ago, huh?
5 years, which is really hard to believe because I remember it like it was yesterday.
Tell us a little bit about that first episode, Jackie.
Well, you know, we were really nervous. There were a lot of people who showed up to dance on the show. It was our very first episode. We were in charge of getting the whole set together. Yeah. A lot of our family was there and friends were there. And so we wanted to impress everyone. And actually, the first show looks better, I think, than the next 10 shows.
Really?
Everything came together really nicely. We had great guests. The Lone Ranger was one of our guests who passed away a couple of years ago, and he was such an interesting performer, blues performer, who always dressed like the Lone Ranger and had such a wonderful personality, and he really interacted with the crowd. You see, kids were really responding positively to him, and it meant a lot to him to be on the show, and people recognized him for months after he had appeared on that show. So it meant a lot to us to be able to document him in that way.
I want you to rock me like my back ain't got no bone.
So as the control booth person, is it a lot smoother for you now, 5 years later?
Yeah, it's a lot smoother, sure, just because, you know, it takes practice. And we have a wonderful crew, and so we've come over the years to learn how we work together, mm-hmm. which is nice. I remember working with Bill Godomsky the first time, our lighting and sound guru. And he knows so much about the studio that he totally intimidated me the first time. But since then, you know, it's just like clockwork. We really work well together. And so developing those relationships has really meant a lot. And you see that in the show. We have a ball just making the show happen. But you don't hear as we're talking to each other.
I see those camera people cracking up and looking at each other. I'm like, what is Jackie talking about in there?
Yeah, yeah. We just love, if we could all be out there dancing, we would be. Yeah.
Okay, so after 200 some episodes in 5 years, do you have one favorite moment you can tell us about?
Man, that's way too hard. That's way too hard. I mean, one of my favorite segments is the L Train line, obviously, just because it comes from one of my favorite shows, Soul Train and the Soul Train line. And because you never know what people are going to do, and it's a moment when you really get to spotlight every single person. Yeah. And they have their moment sort of in the sun. That's my favorite part of the show. Yeah.
You must just sit back there and crack up because there's not a lot of editing. You can just sit there and watch.
Exactly. It's kind of a relaxing moment. Everything is kind of in automatic pilot at that point. And I can really sort of, it's the only time I really get to watch the show.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, any goals or anything that you see for Chicagogo being the skeleton of the system?
That's a good question. I guess we're always kind of thinking about ways to innovate on the show. Coming up with the fantasy dance was an important innovation, and I love that too. I'm always trying to be a better director. You never know what these dancers are going to do, so, or even what the bands are going to do.
Yeah.
So as more and more people get to recognize the style of the show, it's nice to see how bands come on and dancers come on, and they sort of know how to perform.
Mm-hmm.
So we're kind of like influencing each other all the time, and that's something that I hope we can continue, throwing new things into the mix in that way.
All right. Yeah. Sounds great.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Jackie. I'm so glad that we have a chance to spotlight you.
Okay.
Like I said, everybody at home, the show would not be running without Miss Jackie Stewart.
That's right. I'm a woman in the director's chair.
That's right. Thank you, Jackie.
Thanks, Mia.
Doesn't take much to make me happy.
Jack. Hi, Elaine.
Hi.
Hi. This is Miss Mia from Chicagogo.
Okay.
It's so nice to meet you guys.
Thank you. It's nice talking to you.
Congratulations on your fifth year.
Oh, thank you so much. And I wanted to let everybody know at home that I am talking to the inspiration for our show, Mr. and Mrs. Mulqueen from the infamous Chicagogo.
I like that infamous part.
Well, it's true. Without you guys, we would not be able to carry on the music and children's dancing in Chicago torch.
Well, we're impressed.
Yeah.
Oh, we loved it. So I had a couple questions for you guys. Okay, so how long was Chicagogo on the air?
Well, it's kind of, it's interwoven with the Mulqueens. The Mulqueens went on television about 1962, and then somewhere around 1965, Chicagogo was born and stayed on until 1970.
Oh, so the dance show was on for 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, that's...
We went off, the time that you guys are celebrating your fifth year.
That's right. Well, I hope we get to stay on 5 years longer. thanks. And Elaine, you were Pandora, the show's host, who is my inspiration.
Okay, thank you.
What was it like being Pandora? Now, were you Miss Pandora, or was your name just Pandora?
Yeah, just Pandora.
Pandora, and I've seen footage of you, and you are so stylish, and you handle the kids so well. Did you have fun?
Well, yes, because I played only two of the kids. If I had chose to do, and this is no offense against adults.
Okay.
But I just sort of blacked them out.
Oh.
And I only played to the kids. I could only identify with them. I could only be comfortable out there with them.
Oh, that's interesting. Did you think about the cameras being on you and that it was live? Gosh, we get to edit. You guys were on and rolling, right?
No. The puppets were real to me. You know, I never thought of Jack back there, you know, because each one had a very separate, they were all separate people, totally different characters.
Oh,
and I had the kids out there, and that was really, it was all that for me.
Oh, and speaking of the puppets, Jack, can you tell us a little bit about the different characters or puppets you have? We love puppets, you know.
I noticed that with the show.
With Ratso, yeah.
It was built around the circus. Circus, I was always a great love for the circus.
Mm-hmm.
And always tried to get to Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus every time it came to town. So the characters were built around it with a circus horse and a circus lion and an MC and a little girl, which was a bareback rider called Melody. And then it was topped off with a villain.
A villain? Ooh.
Which we called at that time called Count No Account.
Count No Account.
Take off from the melodramatic ones from the older melodramatic days of trying to tying the heroine to railroad track type of approach.
Right. Dun, 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 dun.
The villain.
Wow. Now
was Count No Account the puppet that ate records?
Oh no! That was an actually full costume stagehand that was born out of a thing where was done by the engineer inside the control booth.
Oh.
And when we'd have a vote on a record by the kids in the audience, they would. We started out by just simply throwing the record into the studio when we wanted to get a record that we didn't like playing.
Okay.
We didn't like. We voted down on. So the kids' imagination starts sending in drawings of what they thought the record picker looked like, and we end up building a costume of it from a drawing.
Is that cool?
I forgot about him, you know,
Really? Oh, what a creative way to introduce a character to the show. So the children drew pictures of the record-eating entity, and then you built the costume around the pictures. That is brilliant.
Yeah, that was how it was, and that went over good. Then we ended up taking, we made personal appearances. The record picker would come out with us.
Oh, well, so you had, that's kind of like Ratso, except I didn't have a chance to design Ratso. He kind of came as is.
It's hard dragging him along. It's probably easier taking the record picker around than than bringing Ratso.
He could walk. This record picker could walk.
Ratso can walk, but never on the air. Well, I wanted to wrap it up by saying thank you so much for providing the art world in Chicago with such a great show. And again, you are Chicagogo's main inspiration. Kitty Gogo was a real gift to Chicago, and we really appreciate you taking the time to talk to us.
Well, thank you for interviewing us, and our good luck to Jake Austin and his good wife, Jackie.
Yes, and thank you again for all those beautiful compliments.
Oh, we really mean it. Thanks so much.
Show, Miss Mia.
Whew, oh my gosh. It felt like it took 5 years to do all that.
Yeah, well, it did.
Oh.
5 years.
Oh.
Can you believe it?
I know. I'm so happy that I was able to dance on the very first show, and 5 years later, here I am hosting.
Whoa.
Magic does happen. Wow.
And I was on the first show, and I'm still on it, and I haven't taken a bath yet. Yay.
Oh.
So let's dance out of here, and we'll see you guys for the next 5 years.
Bye. Thanks
Yay.
For watching. We love you guys. Thank you.
Never missing a beat, yeah. Boy, was it neat, yeah. Not just me, she was totally deep when she did the freak with me. Never missing a beat, yeah. Boy, was it neat, yeah.
The girl never misses a beat, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Not just me, she was totally deep when she did the freak with me. It didn't work, no.
It wasn't fucking no more.
Not just me, but she was so needy, but she did things to me.
Yeah. Not just me.
She was totally.